Over a dozen students walked out of a South College formal on Friday evening as the visiting speaker, Rod Liddle, a journalist, gave a talk considered controversial by many, touching on colonialism, trans identity and single-parent families. At the end of the formal, roughly a dozen students walked out in a pre-planned protest before Liddle made his speech. Several more left the room during his address, including a member of the High Table. After Liddle's speech, the JCR president, Sean Hannigan, defended Liddle's right to express his views, but he expressed strong disagreement with the speech. Those listening cheered and clapped at Hannigan's speech. Breaking tradition, hardly anybody stood as members of the High Table left the dining hall, and Liddle was confronted by infuriated students once outside who called him disgusting and racist. Within his speech, the journalist had made several statements, such as, "It is fairly easily proven that colonialism is not remotely the major cause of Africa's problems," and "A person with an X and a Y chromosome that has a long dangling penis is scientifically a man, and that is pretty much scientifically the end of the story." He also suggested that the practice of forced adoption, where unmarried mothers are made to give their babies away, might save many children from strained economic circumstances, mental health problems, low earning expectations, run-ins with the police. Forced adoption was prevalent in the UK from 1945 to 1975. Since the talk, South students have displayed messages such as "Transphobes are not welcome here, Tim." South College Principal Tim Luckhurst had invited Liddle as a guest. The two worked together in the past for the BBC and the Labour Party. Liddle is currently Associate Editor at The Spectator. Today, an anonymous representative of the JCR who was present at the formal told Palatinate TV, "People contacted me after the formal saying it was very disheartening that they had to sit there and hear all of that about their countries when they know it's not true. It wasn't a debate, and that's why it wasn't freedom of speech." Meanwhile, Sean Hannigan, the South College JCR president, told Palatinate, "South College prides itself on being a college where freedom of speech is respected alongside that of the individual." He went on to stress that to question someone's right to exist or their status as whoever they feel to be is not a matter of debate or that of free speech. It is that of human rights. Several university societies, such as the Durham University Labour Club, the Durham Working Class Students Association, and the Durham Intersectional Feminism Society, have published material condemning Rod Liddle's speech. After filming, Palatinate received comments from the university and Tim Luckhurst. Luckhurst reiterated his defence of freedom of speech, saying, "Sincere commitment to freedom of speech is inevitably challenging. It requires us to consider ideas with which we may disagree instinctively. I regard that as a crucial part of the excellent education on offer here at Durham. My intention is never to offend. I hope to stimulate robust discussion and debate. I regret any offence that has arisen, but I fear we have no right not to be offended. As George Orwell noted, if liberty means anything at all, it means the right to tell people things they do not want to hear." Meanwhile, the university said the following, "Durham University upholds freedom of speech within the law. As such, we welcome diversity of opinions from our students, staff, and visitors. Protection of the right to free speech extends to discussion of issues that are controversial, including the expression of views which may shock, disturb, or offend others. We have been alerted to issues arising from a dinner at South College last Friday evening. The university categorically does not agree with the comments reported from a speech given by an external speaker at this occasion, and is concerned at reports that the behaviours exhibited at the occasion fall short of those that we expect. The exchange of ideas within the university should at all times be conducted in a tolerant manner. Everybody has the right to live, work, and study in a respectful environment. We are looking into this as a matter of urgency, and an investigation into the circumstances is now underway."